boys and girls, it's my turn to do a servo review. These just arrived in the mail. What these are is Bluebird brand. They came from Hobbyking. Bluebird brand, and this particular one is the BSM-630MG. It comes in a nice box. I got six of these. These are approximately $16 each. Now, these are standard size servos. I believe they're analog, but they're still fairly fast for analog. They're 0.15, I think, or something like that per second, full range of movement. Now, these puppies at 6 volt are rated for 203 inch ounces of torque, so they should be pretty good. Now, that's for my ailerons, two in each aileron, one in each elevator, and yeah, that makes six right there. And for my rudder, what I ordered from Hobbyking as well, didn't come quite as nicely packaged, but it's the Hobbyking, let's see, what's it called here again? Hobbyking, what is that? 50300X servo. Now this is not standard size, this is a big one. And this one at 6 volts is rated for 417 inch ounces of torque. So that's for the rudder on a pull-pull system. Anyway, I'll unpackage those for you and set them up and give them a test run so that you can see how they work. Okay, now I've set two of these up on a Y harness, and I did that for a reason, because there's going to be two in each aileron, and they do have to travel at the same speed and the same amount of throw. Now, at first glance, they look very well built. They're shiny and they're somewhat transparent. It's very hard to see that with the camera, but if you look at it with the naked eye, they're transparent. You can see the metal gears inside and see the workings, which is kind of a good thing to make sure nothing's wrong. Also, the gauge is a fairly heavy wire, and the connectors are JR style or universal style connectors. So I'll start with the range of movement from side to side. And you see they work quite fast and quite consistent. Both seem to be exactly the same speed, which is important. As far as centering goes, we can watch exactly where they're centered. Centering seems to be perfect. And with small movements, it seems to be perfect. So far, I'm pretty impressed with these servos. One thing I did notice is that in smooth movement, it's a little bit steppy. It's not perfectly ice smooth, but it's still pretty smooth. That's more than good enough for what you need for my application anyway, which is a giant scale airplane. Now, the amount of torque, I felt it. I can't show you that I'm feeling it right now, but I felt it with my hands, and it feels very torquey. So if it's the 203 inch ounces that they state, I'm not sure, but it's definitely very high torque, for sure. Now, moving on to the big one, as you can see, it's quite a bit bigger than the standard side servos, but the advantage to this is that I can use a pull-pull system with just one servo. This one was about $27, I believe it was, and it's rated at 417 inch ounces of torque. And giving it a test, now, it's not as fast as the other servos, but it's still not slow. Full range of movement seems to be pretty much 90 degrees, which is good. Now let's test the centering. Seems to come back to center. Small movements are good. Smooth movement seems pretty smooth. I will admit this servo is a little bit noisy, but does that really matter? So overall, seems like a good servo. This one as well comes with a very heavy gauge wire. So there's my review on these servos. They seem to be fine. Well, one thing I didn't do yet is I didn't test all six of them to make sure all six of them were working. Just look in the description below, and if you see that I have not made a comment against any one of them failing, then you'll know that this review is accurate and stayed accurate. They're going in a 35% Yak 54, powered by the 80cc Turnigy Rotomax motor. Now, test flights, we'll see how well it works, and hopefully they hold up and there's going to be no crashes. very good price, $17, approximately $17, and this one was $27. Now my other option to go Futaba or JR or something like that is in the hundreds, some odd dollars for these kind of servos, the equivalents. Granted, they're not as high quality and they're not as bling, but there's one thing that impresses me most of all when you start talking with bling. If you can set up a really cool plane that's really high performance at a fraction of the price, that's what impresses me. Not spending thousands of dollars unnecessarily for your bling bling. Although I do respect the bling all the same. Anyway, check the reviews to make sure that all the servos were working, and there's my review. So far I'm pretty happy.